In fighting games, performing the Daigo parry or certain combos requires precise timing. Press an input a moment too early or too late, and you fail your combo and maybe die because of it.
Ah.
It's not too unlike learning a song on a musical instrument. Now imagine how hard it would be to play a song you practiced if your guitar did this.
What the hell?
Not only that, but sometimes the note comes out really late or sometimes a little late. It's random. This is what it's like to play fighting games online with delay-based netcode. When you press a button, there's a delay because the game waits for the other side to receive your input before showing the move on both screens. But this is terrible to play in unless the delay between both players is very short. But not everyone has super good internet connections, and not everyone lives in the same region. If everyone could play offline together, lag wouldn't be a problem, but we live in a world where arcades die and viruses live, so netplay matters a lot. Sadly, there's no way to remove the delay between two distant online connections, but Tony Cannon discovered a way to make it so your move appears immediately, even before it reaches your opponent.
I started working on this around in like late 2005, early 2006, and it was because all the games that were coming out for the consoles just had really bad delay-based netcode.
What's insane about this technology is that it's achieved by predicting the future and time traveling. Seriously.
2015? You mean we're in the future?
Let's say there's 45 milliseconds of delay between you and your opponent. If the character you control has no lag and your move comes out before the input reaches your opponent, what does your opponent see? If you kick and your opponent's side sees it 45 milliseconds later, both sides are now 45 milliseconds out of sync, which is no good. But there is a way to get it in sync. When your opponent's side receives your input, it can just skip the first 45 milliseconds of your kick animation. You might be thinking this could look weird or choppy, but at full speed, it's hard to tell. It's like when everyone starts singing happy birthday, but you join in a little late. You skip the first words of the song so you'll be in sync and no one will notice. But if your opponent receives all your actions 45 milliseconds late, what do you look like to them in the meantime? In our kick example, you were shown to be just standing there for 45 milliseconds before kicking. Why did their side think you were just standing there? Because it was its best guess. It was a wrong guess, but it was reasonable considering you were standing there previously. At any given moment, each side is trying to predict what the opponent is currently doing based on the previously received input. And what's crazy is, most of the time it's correct. This is because it doesn't take a fortune teller to predict things one frame into the future.
I'm just gonna assume the thing you did last is the thing you do next, like, forever. Oh, you were holding back to block? I'm gonna assume you're still holding back to block.
Can you guess what my sleeping cats will do in the next frame? If you guess sleep, then you might just be a precog. Obviously, you knew the answer because you saw what they were doing previously. But just like a precog, predictions can be wrong. To clearly show what happens with incorrect predictions, let's just say there's a huge 500 millisecond delay with your opponent. If your opponent is walking forward, your side will correctly predict their position because there's only one direction to predict, forward. But if they suddenly do something different like jump, your side will still think they're walking because it didn't get the memo yet. But the moment your side receives the news that your opponent jumped 500 milliseconds ago, it will instantly roll them back to your opponent's correct position, which is in midair at this point. Hence, rollback netcode. Remember, this was an extreme case. With normal amounts of delay, the amount of rollback would be practically unnoticeable. Rollback netcode works because when the predictions are correct, things are in sync, and when it's not, it gets corrected before anyone notices. Sometimes huge lag spikes can go unnoticed if all the predictions are correct in that time, and you might be surprised just how often the predictions are correct.
How fast do people move the controller? How many inputs are there? There's probably no more than like 5 per second. That's a lot, 5 inputs per second. So that means if there's 60 frames per second, that means you're right more than 90% of the time.
But sometimes you can notice if the game has moments of drastic and instantaneous changes, for example, KOs in Third Strike. The KO pops up and the screen freezes right on the final blow, so if the game predicts someone got knocked out but they actually blocked the hit, you can get a you win just kidding moment. This isn't a big problem in Super Turbo because the final blow just slows down the screen.
Yeah, don't do large disruptive VFX or screen text in the first 2 or 3 frames, however long you expect your rollback to be. The other is like, don't design moves that have very large displacement on the first or second frame.
Developing the game with rollback netcode in mind will minimize these glitchy moments, but weirdness will happen regardless if network delay is too large and the game has to roll back to things that happened too far in the past.
What the f*** was that?
But another way to minimize how far you need to roll back is by delaying everyone's inputs on purpose. If you're late to a party, but they postpone the time, you will be less late or even early. The more you delay everyone's inputs, the shorter the rollback time. But of course, more delay means your character feels laggier. Rollback netcode is usually combined with delay netcode to strike a balance between glitchiness and lag. But there is one more potential problem called rift. Let's say your opponent's console overheats and it slows down their game during an online match. This means their inputs will get to you really late, causing massive rollback glitches on your side, while your inputs will get to them ahead of schedule, making their side play perfectly. This results in one-sided rollback. The netcode must correct the rift to make sure both players have a fair fight.
It's like, I'm on frame 10, you're on frame 14. We should probably both be on frame 12 so that the rollbacks are the same distance.
If rollback netcode sounds more complicated to implement than delay-based, it's because it is.
This is all one tick, right? If we're doing our job right, this takes 16.66 milliseconds and no more.
But if done correctly, it will allow more people to have more playable matches online. I've had excellent games in Punch Planet playing from Korea to California because it uses GGPO, the rollback netcode for fighting games invented by Tony Cannon. He's even made it free to use under the MIT license, and the technology is used in many games already, including old-school arcade games played through Fightcade. Rollback technology is used in AAA fighting games as well, and even Melee has rollback now. If you like fighting games and hate lag, please share this video. For more info on this topic, check out this article by Infill and this video by Hold Back the Block. This was Gerald from Corey Gaming. Thanks for watching. This video was sponsored by ExpressVPN, which is literally the VPN I was using before they approached me to do this. As an American who lives in Asia, there's a lot of content I want to watch that's not always available in my region. A VPN allows me to set my location to wherever I need in order to access stuff like Bob's Burgers on Hulu. My Norwegian wife can even connect to Scandinavian countries to watch shows like Bruin on Netflix. But I also use it for my work. I write and research in tons of different coffee shops in and out of the country, so I'm using unsecured public Wi-Fi a lot. This makes me a target for hackers, but a good VPN secures my connection and gives me a peace of mind when I'm working. My wife and I have been using ExpressVPN since 2018, and it's always been reliable for us. If you want to try it out, go to expressvpn.com/CoreyGaming to get 3 extra months free with a 12-month plan, or just click on the link in the description. Thanks to Tony Cannon for the interview and all you viewers for your support. See you next video or stream.